Hi everyone, welcome to our new video. We are very much excited for knowing how to fix this error which has been giving you a problem, and I'm sure you have because of that after searching online and you did not get anything until when you go to our video. We're lucky that we're having you today, and that error is going to be fixed in just a few seconds. You're going to see how to fix it and you never ever fail to do it again. I'm here to say if you're using Windows, I'll tell you what to do, and if you're using Linux, that's what you're gonna use. If you're using Mac and other operating systems, once you know about computers, you're gonna know the problem, and once you know what's the cause, then it's easier to look for to fix. So we know the cause, and we're gonna give you the reason why you're facing that problem, and also we're gonna show you how to fix it. We downloaded WordPress from wordpress.org, then we entered, then we went and download. So once download, after downloading, we did extract our WordPress, which is here. Please let me get that. So it's here, it's extracted here, but now we're gonna call it a different name, which is gonna be no, we cannot use that because that is a different issue. Let me delete that, and I'm gonna extract this here. After doing that, I'm gonna stop services. Guys, be patient, you're gonna see what you need to do to see. Service stop Apache 2. Stopping those. So now let me recall the command, which means I have to delete this and say Apache 2 stop. Once we stop that, we also want to stop MySQL. MySQL stop. After doing that, still we're going to restart those services again. I'll call this command, recall this command, and say start. You don't need to do that. I'm doing it for some reason. And also, if you're using Windows, don't get yourself worried. You'll know what to do. Start. Okay, yeah, no, that's crazy, that's good, we're fine. We now going to do something. So once we get our WordPress here, we're gonna rename it to something like web. We're gonna say web press. We're gonna call it web press. Okay, once we name it web press, we copy that folder. If you're using WAMP, you're gonna copy and put it. It's already in WAMP. I'm just showing you the steps why this is happening. Because if you have the problem, it simply means you did things the right way. I copied, but something went wrong. I copied and I put it under HTML. If you're using Windows, you know your folder should be in HTML in your www directory. Even us, we went to www directory. So now we went to HTML and we're gonna paste that. So once we paste that, we're going to create what they call a new database. So that new database is gonna be created under PHP MySQL, my admin, my PHP my admin, PHP. Okay, it's gonna be PHP my admin. So once we here, we have to create a folder web press. We're gonna create a a database called WordPress. Once we're done with WordPress, we save. After saving, don't put any kind of tables and stuff. Leave WordPress is gonna create that for you. And then after that, since we have that folder there, we go to localhost. Localhost. What's gonna be here is gonna be WordPress. Okay, remember even our password is WordPress. You know, when you on this page, it's gonna ask you, it's gonna say welcome to WordPress. Before getting started, we need some information on the database. Where you saw we created a database, but there's something you didn't see. Maybe you have it already. You will need to know the following items before proceeding. 1. Database name. Do you have it? You must have it. 2. Database username. 3. Database password. 4. Database host. Then the 5, they say table prefix if want to run more than one WordPress in a single database. Yes, that's great. So if you want to run 2-3 WordPresses in a single database, you better prepare your prefix. It's not something difficult, but if you're creating one database, it's no problem. We're going to use this proceed and saying we're going to use the information to create a wp-config file. If any reason this automatic file creation does not work, don't worry, all this does it fill the database. All this does is fill in the database information to configuration file. You may also simply open config example, you can see it, sample.php in a text editor, fill in your information and save it as w. You can see now what they say. We're gonna go to the prompt, that's where we're gonna come back here. Copy that information, put it on a text pad so that you can remember. In all likelihood, these items were supplied to you by your web host. If you don't have this information, then you will need to contact them before you can continue, if you are already. So I'm installing this offline, but if you're installing it online, it simply means you have to ask. If you don't know how to, your database name or your database password and your root name, whatever host. But most I'm gonna show you, once I show you, you know all those things are almost the same anyway. So you can create that. Most web hosting companies, they give you access to that. You can create them yourself. But the error here, what you're gonna see, it's fixed. Okay, so what's your database name? We call it WordPress, you remember? But we have to be sure, 100% sure, that we're dealing with WordPress. Okay, copy, click here, copy this and this little thing, WordPress, to be there. So never make a mistake on a database, you're gonna be into trouble anyway. So you do that and you say username. You see the username, we know it. And also put in password, we know it. And also leave everything the way it is, unless if the host is different, but just leave it like local host. Even if you're working online, most times it's like the same. And say, so if you want a prefix, in case you're using many databases on one WordPress database, so you can change that. But leave it if you're using one, then you say submit. Once you submit, you can see be in trap, whereby they're gonna tell you you're unable to write to this file. You can create wp-config file manually and paste the following text into it. You remember, create, if you want to, they said you can create this manually. This is gonna be the best cheap way for people who are using Windows. But in Linux, I'm gonna show you a very easy way how to do it. So in Windows, let's see, guys on Windows guys, be attentive. You go to WordPress. There is a file called wp-config sample. You see this one? You can copy and paste it there. Then you can see. You see what they say? It's the same file, but you remove this and you leave .php. So what you do, you go inside here if you're using Windows, and you scroll down. Don't do anything else they didn't tell you to do. Scroll down. You can see this is where, you see your prefix here. You can read all this information, you're gonna understand what it do. So if you are a Windows guy and things are tough now, you can't, don't know what to do, look at this database password, db password, password here. You type in your database password here if you're a Windows guy. Even Linux you can do that if you want to. They say MySQL database name. You put your database name here. Then here you say database, they say name of database for WordPress. You put it here. This one you put the user name, like, you know, root. Your username is root. You see what you put in here is what you put in when you log into your PHP my admin. You see the first login, which says put in a username and password, is that what all you put here and here. So that up here, that's where you put your database. Once you finish here, you must save this file. You must save this file like wp-config.php. You remove all of this, then you put .php here. Once you save like that, your problem is fixed if you're using Windows and any operating system. But now we want to do it using a code, so I guess you guys will understand me, because if you don't, let me do it practically for you. But I won't put the right things, because I can put the right things if I want, it's fine. But now it's gonna cost us. It's gonna install the WordPress. Okay, do what I'm telling you to do. I'm gonna do for the guys on Linux to the simple thing to do. You just have to repress this and rename the file to what they're telling you here to do. Then you save it in that folder, then you're done. So remember here what they say to you. They said, if we can follow, they said you can create the wp config, you can see, and paste this information there. You can see what it says. You paste that information there. This information, this page, the WordPress is gonna write the configuration, whatever the password and whatever, is gonna do that for you. Once you write that, you can write that and don't put username and password, or you can write it and put it. So if you don't put it, WordPress is gonna do it for you. If you put it, then it's not going to do it for you. So now the Linux guys, or guys who are using the black screen, I'm using the white one, no problem. What you're gonna do, you're going to go to your folder there. Guys, this is a permission problem, it's not something major. You click into that and say open in terminal. Once you get open in terminal, you're gonna have to copy this on this line, you get me? So once you copy that line, you can close this, and we go create another terminal here. In the terminal, the reason why we just wanted the URL where your stuff is, where your folder is. So we're gonna give it permissions, like 100% read, write, and whatever. So we're giving WordPress permissions to write on our file and do everything it wants to do. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna say chmod, Then we say if you not sudo, you got to put sudo here. Sudo chmod. Then you say space minus capital R space 777 777. Depends which permissions you want, but I'm giving it a 777 because we're just here on the tutorial. You paste that link where your WordPress is, the folder, then you hit enter, the problem is gonna be gone. We're gonna see, hit enter, all is done, all is well. Go back to your screen here where you got that problem, and you're gonna do this. I wanted to copy it also, this kind of problems. Okay, I wanted to copy one thing there, so but it's fine. We're done with what we're gonna do, but we're gonna go back here down, and we fix that since it's fixed anyway. We're done, so we just go back after pressing that. Then you put in the password because the password goes out. Okay, we're gonna put the password here. Make sure everything's fine. Then you say submit. Once you submit, you can say all right, shine. So everything is what? Everything's fine. So there's no need for you to do anything else but to proceed with developing your website. After fixing that error, maybe it gave you a problem, then you can see that the installation has started already. The password, you can put 12345 if you want to. If you want to say admin, you can say admin. Then you say website name is gonna be a real fixing. Okay, whatever you want to put your username, you can say admin if you want to put admin. Then you confirm using a weak password. If you used weak one, then you can put any email address. You can put up email address called javawaste5@gmail.com, javawaste. Then you say yes, then you don't click this, you just say install. Yeah guys, you can see the WordPress is installing, and we're happy to see that the problem has been fixed. You like it or not, we finished with this, and it's just busy installing, unless if there can be something we don't know. But you can see it says success, then say login. We're gonna go to login, put admin, then you'll be able to log into your WordPress. You can see now you good to go. You can now install a lot of things you want to install, or put themes, put plugins, and all that. Thanks for watching guys, see you in the next video. Please hit the subscription button and also that small ring bell stuff. So if you want any tutorial, please talk to us in the comment box below. This is Azania Tutorials, and every day we post a new video, 2, 3, 4, whatever we do, we post it, and every day we do posting. We committed to this, and we committed to for searching new errors, bringing new solutions. You go on, you proceed, you get a problem, you come here, you search, you ask us, we do that, we help you if you can, we can. Thanks guys, and please, we really appreciate your support. Please keep on watching our YouTube channel because we do bring relevant stuff. See you in the next video guys.